I'm in a little different position in this sense that as a researcher I work a lot about another type of approach, because you are speaking about the relationship between consciousness and brain state, and you use terms like coding, like circuitry, like information, and so, sorry, I work on the other side, that is. For me, the problem is how the brain manipulates information. What is the relationship between information, as we use in biology or neuropsychology, and the notion of information is used in this computer, and how the complex dynamics of brain, chaotic dynamics. Originally, this meeting was also for make a commentary about Freeman's book. You know, Walter Freeman's approach is strictly related with the discovery of chaotic dynamics in the brain, and so one of the most puzzling and fascinating problem for me, but for many also physicists, is how chaos can manipulate information, and how is it possible to use chaotic dynamic networks, chaotic dynamic system, on neural networks based on chaotic dynamics, like it is the brain, for solving, for instance, quantitative problems of memorization. Because you know that the enormous amount of memory, of information storing that is possible, for instance, in brain, but also the same problem we have in genetics when we use some idea that all the information is in the genetic code. A winner at the beginning of the informational approach to the genetics made a very simple calculus, because science is also mathematics, at least hard science. And so very simple calculus, because you know that we have 10 power 17 cells in our adult body, okay? And so all of them derives from one only cell, bifurcating it, that is. And so, you know, it's very simple when you study information theory at school, that if I have here a system that I need 1 bit for putting the system here, and 1 bit for choice between two different lines. And so 2 bit for one choice, and then 4 bit for two choices, 8 bit, 2^3 for a choice. So when we pass from 1 to 10^17, we need an amount of information, if information is coded in this way, of 2^10^17. That is a number that cannot be calculated at all. No matter in the universe can embody all this information. So it is obvious that information, as is computed in biological system and also in brain, is absolutely different from information as we are acquainted with the Shannon theory of information and so on. And so my approach as a scientist, that is a computer scientist in this field, and as a philosopher of science, is this, that is, we have consciousness, that is something subjective. You asked for, please give me a definition of consciousness. It is like to ask a physicist, please give me a definition of energy. You cannot give, because it's a primitive notion. That as you use energy in physics, you cannot explain energy in physics, but you suppose that exists. So that in psychology, as far as you have to do with consciousness, you cannot define consciousness, because it is a primitive for the distinction between physiology or neurology and psychology. Otherwise, they're the same. And so also when, for instance, I brought with me this last number of time, because it seems possibly prepared for our meeting, so we discussed a lot of things. Oh, here there is a very, very simple mistake that is made over all the papers here. That is, because it is obvious that each mental state is related with the neural state. So Surely, brain states have some causal influence on the mental state, and this is now a scientific evidence. The mistake is this, that is to confuse necessary condition, I'm a philosopher of science, a logician too, necessary condition with sufficient condition. Because it is evident that each psychological state, each conscious state has a correlate in the brain, also the more mystic one. And I am a priest, and so I worked also a lot about the psychology of mystic experience of saints and so on. And for Catholics, that is, I am Catholic, and I am also Aristotelian as a philosopher, it's absolutely obvious that also the more spiritual experience that you have has a physical basis. Because in my approach, not only as a philosopher, as Aristotelian, but also as a scientist, as a computer scientist, the brain state is not only matter. The brain state is matter and form. Energy and information. And energy and information. And information is a metaphor that is cannot be distinguished from energy and so from matter. Only if you consider a classic Turing machine, that is the computer according to the mechanistic approach of the Turing machine. I don't know if all the people is acquainted with this notion, but because effectively for implementing the calculus of a Turing machine, I need a stable, stationary system from the physical standpoint. That is, I need essentially linear dynamic system. And otherwise, you cannot predict the final state. And there are a lot of bibliography on these topics. That all the classical mechanical physics, all the classical mechanics, the Newtonian mechanics, you can simulate by a Turing machine, that is, by a classical computer, because are two different connotations of the same denotatum, like the morning star and the evening star denotate the same object, that is the Venus planet. Okay, it's famous. But if you work with nonlinear systems, unstable and non-stationary, like a chaotic system is, and like the brain dynamics is, and like a lot of metabolic systems are, you have this strange phenomenon that without absolutely violating the principle of energy conservation, you have a system that can generate information. That is, the puzzle of the genetic code, but it's not a code, because a code in information theory means something related with a Turing machine. So it's not a code. That is, it's not preview the branching till the adult, okay? It's not a code in a technical sense. So the secret is this, that the organism growing up generates information through the relationship also with the environment. And the same is in the brain. That is, the brain, the ability of brain is to produce a surplus of information. But this surplus of information is not some spirit, okay, despite probably, okay, you are a priest, and so in this way demonstrate what is the spirit, okay, no. After, if we have time, I wrote 1 year ago a nice paper. I called it too nice. is from information to spirit, and then, this surplus of information is related with the capability of the system to generate information that is not given in the initial conditions. And so the correlate of consciousness, or the subjectivity of consciousness, is not only the energetic flow, okay, that is the circuitry that we can reveal by brain imaging, like a tester. If I put a tester in this on this computer for measuring the energy exiting from each transistor, I have the information flow. I make the image of this computer, the imaging. Like our colleagues in neurophysiologists may, that is, they put the tester. The tester is electroencephalography, PET, and so on, so on, so on. All the system, magnetic resonance, and so on. But this is, they give us, in this way, the energetic flow of the brain. And it's very nice to see how this energetic flow is related with the conscious state that is expressed by the patient, that is, by the person which brain you are observing. But the other correlate of this subjective state is the information manipulated by the brain. And so, where in a gaudic system put information the gaudic system has the capability of information storing that effectively human brain seems to have, but we don't know how it has. For instance, in this discussion about information, what I appreciate a lot is that it is completely overcome the old approach of the grandmother cell, that is, to suppose that the brain memorizes information like the hard disk of a computer in some physical space, so that I have the cell for recovering, for remembering my grandmother, my sister, and so on. No. Is the dynamics between hippocampus, between limbic system, okay, amygdala, hippocampus, and so on, and cortex. And this completely agree what we expect from the standpoint of the gaudic dynamics approach and for information processing in the complex system. And so I want to stop here, otherwise I speak before, I don't speak now, I speak too much. So in equilibrium, okay. But the gaudic system are stable, far from equilibrium. This is nice. And so and so I agree in a lot of this type. For instance, also when you spoke about synchronization, mm-hmm. this is phenomena that we can simulate very easily with the gaudic system that is in the laboratory. And with properties very, very nice that we can correlate easily also what the neurophysiologists find in the brain by studying the real brain. So, I want to stop and only for saying what is my approach. This is my approach is an objective study of brain, of consciousness means, not only the energetic flow, okay, the energetic imaging of the brain, but also the information processing in the brain. The information processing in the brain is not the information processing of bit in a computer. And one of the most intriguing mysteries for scientists today, for physicists today, is to study how a nonlinear system can generate and manipulate information. And the brain is surely one of the topics for the best study in this field. And I stop.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
I'm not sure how much about I understood, but...